Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com.
FL12.5 has officially been released from Area 51. We got the update we were looking for. So many features, so little time. If you want all the features, honestly, I'm not going to cover every feature because there's so much that they've added. I want you to go to the original video by ImageLine. It's just so much in here. So firstly, let's go through it as if we were creating a track. I think that's the easiest way to explain the new features, to show you how it goes down. So let's open up Harmore. Harmore got a facelift, y'all. Got a facelift, looking brand new. Some brand new kicks. Let's open up Harmore. I love this plugin for its saw patches specifically. Let's open up Filter 1 Frequency. Let's turn it on. Go to Tempo Mode. Let's right click. What I'm going to do is create a fade for the cutoff so it goes, you know, over time. It's like you're closing your mouth. So let's play a chord real quick. I just love that sound. Let's set the low amount for the frequency knob. And that's going to be the minimum value. Let's turn up resonance just a tiny bit. Just love that sound. Just a crazy cool sound. And that's just the raw sound. We didn't even really dig into the effects yet. Wait till we get the Fruity Delay 3. That's too low. All right, so let's program a track. Let's start. So there's so much to go through. let's do this first. Let's program a chord. Where we at here? So we're playing E minor and D, F sharp, A. Let's turn this down a teeny bit. G, B. Okay, this is gonna be our first chord. Now, let's go one by one. Let's send this to track one in the mixer. In track one, we're gonna open up the new plugin, Fruity Delay 3. So drop all your other plugins that have delays. This is it. All right, so firstly, there's a lot of stuff going on. You have the delay time, which is your typical delay functions like tempo sync, and this is a new keep pitch, which is different. You have tempo setting, the time, you have offset, time offset, the right and left timing when it bounces left and right, ping pong modes, which is stereo delay, or if you want it straight up and down the center, mono delay. It looks like you have a stereo spread knob to even determine how wide of a delay you want, which is incredible. You have the feedback knob. Now on top of this, you have new features like the cutoff frequency. So you can add a low pass filter to your, even you can add more than a low pass filter now. You can add a high pass filter. Before you could only add a low pass filter, but now you can add a high pass filter. So let's hear what that would sound like. Let's do high pass filter. And this is great for vocals. Let me show it on my vocals. It's actually better to hear it on vocals because I use it, this effect all the time on vocals, on vocals. On vocals. Let me turn this off. All right, so to have a ping pong effect, it's on ping pong, but you're like, why isn't it ping ponging? You got to turn your pan width up so it knows how far left and right to ping pong. Ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong. Let's do high pitch. Let's do high pitch. Let's turn our cutoff down. Babe. Man, we can go crazy with the Fruity Delay 3. I'm going to save that for an in-depth video, but the stuff you can do with this thing. Let's add it to Harmore, and let's add... Okay, here's what we're going to do with this plugin. Let's turn down the input. Let's do ping pong, left, right, pan width. Let's do the four steps. Let's turn down the wet level. So the delay is not as loud. Now let's add a high pass filter, which we did. The cutoff is going to be somewhere around 50% resonance. Let's turn that up. It's going to add a little sting. Let's pull our feedback lower. Let me drop this down an octave just to hear. Nah, it's too crunchy. Now let's add what's called modulation. This is something that it's a pitch bend to the delay response. So when it goes beep, bing, bing, bing. It's gonna pitch. It's gonna wobble the pitch. So it's gonna go bing. You know, it's gonna go up and down in pitch. And this is great for the new 80s type of thing we got going on in music. So you hear that pitch bending? This is awesome when you have really thick sounds because now the pitch is changing. So it's like your delay is not just repeating what it's hearing. It's actually detuning what it's hearing. So now you get it's almost like adding more voices of a sawtooth. And I'm playing the complete wrong chord. Where are we at here? Bend. Let's add that bass octave, thicken it up a little bit. We're cooking with grease. I'm gonna be a little more finesse with the envelope here, so don't worry about what I'm doing. I'm just trying to make it sound a little more. So we get really cool 80s tones very easily. Those pads that made us love the 80s sound, which is coming back. Let's see if we can come up with the next chord. All right, now let's look at the next chord. Let's see what's gonna work here. Gotta love the 80s warmth. Okay, so when you don't know if it's the right chord or not, chances are it's not. So let's switch that to a major, what is this, like a 13th? We have the major triad, then we have the 7th, 9th, wow, major 11th. I just love that. You know, that solid tone at the bottom. And that fruity delay really adds that resonance ringy sound that we need. It's not too ringy. I love that pitch bend. Man, okay, so let's go to pattern 2. And let's pull up something else that got vectorized, FPC. Now, this plugin is great. Okay, for a lot of different reasons. Let's right click. Let's go to the house kit. Boom, 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 chicka, boom, boom. Okay, so this really isn't like a house track, but let's use the house drums. Now on the left side of the playlist, you're now gonna see a new area, and that's why I pulled up pattern 2. You're gonna see the pattern, I don't know the official name, so don't even quote me on this. I'm going to call it the pattern selector. That's probably not what it's called. But I like the pattern selector or pattern picker, whatever you want to call it. Pattern picker sounds cooler. Peter Piper picked the pattern picker. Pepper. So we're going to add pattern 2. and what you can do now is also, I figured this out randomly. If you go to pattern 1, it used to be a long drawn out process to convert stuff to audio. Now it's just one click away or two clicks away. You right click the pattern that has the audio, such as pattern 1. We're not on pattern 1. And what you can do is right click and render as an audio clip. So this is awesome for like 1,000 different reasons, especially if you're making Drake songs, any modern trap, any kind of modern hip hop. You can reverse audio. You can chop audio. There's so many things you could do with audio that you can't do in MIDI, like cut the reverb off right away. You know, it's little stuff like that. So let's render as an audio clip and let's take off the master effects. They suggested you don't add master effects. Those are the effects that occur on the master track. We don't have any effects on that track. We do have a delay on the insert effects. And we're going to keep it wavy. Leave the remainder. We don't want to cut the remainder. What else do we have here? All that stuff was already there. Trim PDC delay. Good, good. Start. So what it just did is now you're going to see an audio clip. Now there's 3 different things you can go through with the pattern selector. I'm just calling it the pattern selector. Let's call it the picker. Okay. You can pick automation clips, audio clips, and patterns. So now we have a new audio clip, and all we have to do is right click and actually you can preview it. Let's do that. just all the sauce. And it plays the whole thing, which is great. Let's left click, drag that into the playlist. Left click, drag it atop pattern 3. So now we have the same MIDI, but in audio form. The reason we do this is, let's say you want to reverse the audio. You can't really do that in MIDI. So let's go here. Let's go to channel settings. Let's go to reverse. And now it's backwards, which is a little unorthodox. Let's pull it to the left. What we need to do is align it with the grid. This is going beyond the scope of the video, but I just want to show you what it's going to sound like. Let's go to snap to grid none. Pull this until it's up to a vertical line. Let's zoom on in with our mouse scroll, middle scroll. And let's grab our snap to grid, change it back to bar mode, grab that slice tool, hit shift, right click, get rid of the excess. And now we're going to pull this whole thing to the left. So now it's the same thing, but in reverse. You can't do this in MIDI. And let's say you wanted to create some kind of sample feel. Like, I know this is dramatic, but I'm going to slice out the audio. And this is the difference between audio and MIDI. You can't just cut MIDI off. It keeps going. Like, if there's a reverb in your insert, it's going to keep going. But the delay effect cuts off because we cut the audio off. It doesn't continue delaying the sound. So that's what I mean by using audio is super powerful for many different reasons. Now, that would have been great if we had a melody. I'm going to keep it forward until we create the melody. I'm going to see what the melody sounds like reversed. So we're going to leave that as an option. Just wanted to show you that real quick. And you can even right click delete the audio track so you don't take up unnecessary space. Let's go to pattern 2. We got the house drums. Let's come up with a rhythm for this. So let's do. Doesn't mean it has to be house just because it's the house drums. So let's go here to song. Let's go to pattern mode. Turn the metronome on. Let's go to song mode. The timing here is a little different than what I expected. I don't know what I was thinking in my head, but clearly it wasn't to the BPM. What was that? Let me figure out what tempo I was going up. Boom, ch, boom, ch, boom, boom. 85 BPM. No wonder it was off. I was beatboxing at 85 BPM and our track was at 100. Let's just make this like a house. So let me record my vocal because that's a nice melody. Let me arm a track for recording. Let me turn my filter on. Okay, so I'm going to record that and I'm going to show you how to sidechain the new audio that we create. Let's record audio into playlist. So of course you want to put a bigger spin to it. That's just a rough draft for an audio clip. And the reason I added that is to sidechain it. So let's get into sidechaining quickly. The audio clip, let's send that to track 3. Also, what I love that they did with the audio colors. Now it looks like a pattern versus like a random purple color and then a random gray color. So they made it very uniform. Image line is definitely listening to the users, and that's what makes this company such a great company. They actually pay attention to what people want. They don't just, you know, throw in an update and make you pay $1,000 to update. They actually go through your workflow. I'm sure they check out a bunch of videos as well. Let's send this to track three. And let's add some cool effects to this. Firstly, let's add pitcher. Let's do minimum value 25. Now the thing is, I probably should have outlined our key. So let's figure this out with harm more. So those are the three notes I'm playing. Okay, so those are in our scale. We know that. We know this, man. And you know this, man. Let's add that in our scale. Let's kind of reverse engineer the scale. So to create this scale really quick, you just go down and listen to the notes that you think sound good. No, that doesn't sound good. I think E's in there. No. Okay, that's our scale. I know that's very weird, but that's how scales are made. Now, let's go to pitcher, and let's type in these notes into pitcher. So, where we at? F sharp is in there. F is not in there. So, drop the F. You feel me? Drop the F. You flail me? FL gang in the building. G, we're keeping G. Getting rid of G sharp. Keeping A. Getting rid of A sharp. Keeping B, keeping C, getting rid of C sharp, keeping D, getting rid of D sharp. So that's our scale. So now when my vocals go through pitcher, which is, correcting the pitch, just like AutoTune, but even better because you can right click and automate these things, which makes FL's image line plugins superior when it comes to FL Studio. You can automate them, which I can't, Tory Lanez used it on the, what was that song? Dream. They modulated or automated the format knob. So you can get pretty crazy with this. Is that a little format? Let's do something real cool. Since I'm so excited, 12.5 is out. Let's really mix this thing with all stock plugins. Fruity Compressor. Let's do threshold, -20. Now, one caveat to this is pitcher delays the audio a little bit. So just keep that in mind. So what I'm going to do here to compensate, you don't have to worry about this. It's just a side note. You could re-record it, but what I'm going to do is just move the audio a little to the left so it picks up earlier. So let's do alt left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's what I do to compensate. Okay, we're obviously too early. Let's do this again. Again, there's workarounds for this. It's not like it's a bad thing. It's just, that's what it is for now. All right, let me line this up a little bit better. 1, 2. How are we coming in that early? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I know what I did. Okay, so it wasn't on none, so I moved it over like 30 if it were on snap to grid none. Let's add that compressor. 2-to-1 ratio. Let's add some makeup gain. Pull the threshold down a little bit more. Let's add a parametric EQ 2. About to sauce it up with the high shelf. Oh, cut off on me. High shelf time. Let's use a high pass filter to get rid of that random rumble at the bottom. Yeah. Then our magical delay, Fruity Delay 3. Where we at, baby? Where we at? Let's turn the input down. We don't need that much delay. Let's turn the feedback down a bit. Turn the wet level down a tad. And let's do ping pong mode, full pan width. Now what I want to do is a band pass. So I usually do high pass, but let's do band pass. I'm going to turn the resonance up so we can hear the cutoff frequency. And Turn the wet level up. Can't really hear the delay. Man, that's so perfect. This is a perfect. This is like becoming my new favorite plugin. I know I'm obsessing over it. Let's also add a little modulation there. You can barely tell, but it's pitch bending. Let's make a new track, track four. We're gonna call that side chain. Now I'm gonna send things that I want to duck in volume to this track. So whatever I want to go boom, I mean not boom, but whatever I want to go, you know, kind of duck in volume, go down in volume, come back up. Let's go to track three. We're gonna right click the up arrow, route to this track only. So I'm sending the vocals directly to track four. So now it's accounted there. Also, I want the pads to be ducked as well, or side chain. Let's go to track one, which is our pad. Right click, route to this track only. It's going to send that pad directly to the sidechain. Now we need to set up the sidechain. Let's go to the sidechain track. Let's open up where we at, Fruity Limiter. And let's go to the compressor mode. What we need to do is set it up to be a sidechain. So in short, if you don't understand mixing, just follow these instructions. Pull your threshold down to negative 30 or so, or lower, depending on how much kind of dipping you want. Set your ratio to 10 to 1 or higher. If you don't know what the value is, just read it up here in the top left. I'm going to go full 20 to 1 ratio. And leave. You're going to adjust the attack and release as you go. So now we need to send the kick to the sidechain. Let's click on the kick. Track 2, we're going to right click sidechain to this track. So now the kick is a sidechain to the sidechain track. Now we go back into Fruity Limiter. We right click the sidechain window and select. Insert two. I'm getting tongue twisted here. That's our kick. So the kick is now the key. So now you're gonna hear the volume dip as the kick hits. Also, it looks like I have my, oh, you know what? The whole FPC is routed to track two. So this is great because it saves us time. I was gonna say I wanted to route the clap to the sidechain as well. So just be careful. Remember, you loaded up the FPC. So if you played hi-hats, it would duck that as well. There's a way to route the kick drum to have a different output. We're not going to get that complex, but there's a way to send the kick to its own track. Okay, just keep that in mind. I'm not going to, you know, get into all that. Let's just keep it basic. Let's just right-click, clone this so we can create a hi-hat rhythm. Send that to track 5, something unused. And let's create a hi-hat rhythm. Let's go to pattern 3 and let's zoom on in. You won a new car. I don't know why I'm so hype. This update has me hype on some extraterrestrial type stuff. Okay, so let's zoom in. And so we want to go. Wait. I want to try something else, so I'm adding that little ghost note because I want to try the swing parameter. I want to hear what it sounds like. So it's the same pattern, and let's swap that out for the open hi-hat. Let's turn up the swing parameter, see what it does. Great housey. Now what I'm going to do is use Fruity Reverb directly on the vocals because we have a wet, dry wet balance. Let's do Fruity Reverb too. Also, I'm doing it directly on this. Usually I use an aux track, track 100. If you don't know what I'm talking about, it's fine. Just know that I'm doing this only in this scenario because we have the sidechain set up. Let's add the decay, pull out the width, cut out the lows. Oh, So what? It's a beat without bass. Bay. Let's use 3X OSC just to show you how we can use this. A lot of people overlook this plugin. It's super powerful. Let's pull down oscillator 2 and 3. Let's go to the sawtooth. And let's pull the coarse pitch down. Let's give it an envelope. Turn that envelope on. Turn everything down except decay. And what we want to do here, we want to detune it. No, we don't. Never mind. Forget what I just said. Actually, wait. I want to use, there's a plugin I want to use. Let's use GMS. It has a patch in here that I want to use. Let's keep it on banks, bass, and slide through. It's one of these analogs. Let's turn off the reverb glue. We don't want the reverb. So it's kind of hard to hear everything. So let me crank the bass up so we can hear it. So boom, something like that. I don't know what I want to do yet. Let's do start with the bass. Let's crank the bass up even louder. And we are on track. Wrong track, no wonder. Let's send this to track 6. Boom, 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 boom. What I love to do, because it has swing parameter on, I love to just kind of have notes in a row. So it's dun 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 instead of dun 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 dun. It's dun 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 dun. A lot of octave play. Let's do the same thing. So I know I'm getting a little abstract. It's because I'm going by ear. Also, I'm going to sidechain the bass, so we haven't routed the sidechaining yet. Oh, I wanted to show you something in the piano. I almost forgot. Let's go through the piano roll options. View, I think it was under. Was it under view? What was it under? I should know this. Wait, oh, here it is. Go to view, go to time, and go to mini piano roll preview enable. So now you get to see, like, let's say you're zoomed in and you don't know the context of where you are. You're just like, I'm zoomed in somewhere. At the top, it tells you exactly where you are. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Perfect. You could do this in the playlist as well. If you go to playlist options view, go to mini playlist preview enable. We're cooking with grease, ladies and gentlemen. Now let's say you name these. Let's see. I think it's track. Now I'm trying to remember what they did in the image line video. I'm being completely honest. I think they highlighted the tracks, changed colors. That's not what they did. They definitely went to patterns. Hit shift, highlighted all the patterns. Go to color. Where is our color? Rename and color. And there's a gradient function. So let's say you want to go from a gradient of, let's create our own gradient. We want to go from hot pink to orange, one of my favorite gradient styles. Let's go to hot pink to orange, more of a yellowy orange. Where's our yellowy? The yellow. And let's call this enter. And now our stuff is nice and colorful. Look at that, is pretty. That's very pretty. That is inspiringly pretty. And now at the top, you can actually see, like if I zoom in, you can see where that stuff is. So let's say I was way over here. You're like, oh, I have pink stuff in the beginning of my song. And just left click your way back. FL, man, Image Line did a crazy job. Just little stuff like this inspires you as a music producer. Even if it's not 1,001 plugins, just stuff like this really does inspire. Dum, dum, bum, bum. There we go. That's our baseline. Let's hit control down, pull it down an octave. Let's swap out the bass. Clipping, we're not XXXTentacion. Let's try out different basses. I never went through the bass. This one sounds cool. We're definitely using that one. Bass 6 for the win. Or bass 2 MC. Whoops. All right, let's send that to sidechain. Let's right click the up arrow, route to this track only. And now let's go to sidechain. Just make sure that your sidechain key is still the kick. Right click, go to insert 2. Good, we're set. Like we're in a fashion show. That bass, I'm hype. Oh man, do I have to go further? If you don't have FL 12.5, what are you doing with your life? It's like the DeVry commercial. Are you at home sitting on the couch looking at this commercial while I talk to you? Oh yeah, you are, because you're listening to me right now. Well, go ahead to imageline.com, download FL Studio 12.5. That bass, yikes. Now let's make that unique, because I said I was going to reverse the melody. So since the vocal is our melody, let's go to, I made it unique by clicking that icon. I did it really fast, so sorry. Make unique, and then that's a new thing. I'm trying to look at the nomenclature difference. I don't see one. Is there a microphone? Whatever the nomenclature difference is, we are going to click here to channel settings and reverse that bad boy. Now it's in reverse. Let's hear what it sounds like. Let me turn off the pad for a second. Sick. All right, that part sounds a little weird. So we might chop that part out, but the beginning, this part sounds dope. That sounds very demonic. That was actually kind of cool, but what I'm just going to do is repeat that first part. And just get rid of that last tail. Let's see what that sounds like with the chord. I'm not even sure. That last note.
Yeah.
Cut that off. That bass. Go over top and add another melody. Let me see if I can freestyle melody. If not, whatever.
Whatever.
Let's see. Now I should add pitch to my voice. Let's do that first. And what was our scale? Somebody hint. Oh, did I delete our scale? No. I think we had. Let's look at our key. Okay. I don't know why I deleted the scale. I wanted to show you all these features in real time. That's why I did the video. So let's see. We got E. We have F. We have F. We don't have F sharp. I thought we dropped F. We did drop F. We had F sharp. This is not our scale. Don't look at this chord to the right. That's called a borrowed chord. So we had E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D. Okay, so everything was white except the F sharp. So let's do no black keys. And I should be in key. Minimum value 25 because my voice is lower. Let's add a format here.
Let's make me sound really cool. I sound like the devil. I forget where this is from, but I sound really weird.
Alright, let's do it. Just a little bit lighter. So let's add that top line melody. I like that.
Freedom fly.
I know it's a little delayed. You can't hear it, but I can. Let's do automation. I mean, excuse me, audio into playlist is good.
Freedom fly.
Okay, so that, whoa, that sound weird. Okay, back to normal, almost, hold on. You're probably like, what is this guy on? Image Line FL Studio 12.5 made me high. I'm blaming you guys. Okay, no, I'm really hype. I don't know what it is. They really stepped it up big time. So let's pull the vocals a little to the left. And I'm going to sidechain this vocal. Let's send this, excuse me, to the mixer track 7. We're going to right click, route to this track only. So it sends that vocal to the sidechain. So now the melody that we just created is about to be sidechained. I'm about to add a whole bunch of processing to it. So it sounds really cool. Fruity compressor. Let us do negative 20 dB or so. Zero attack. I just wanted to really pull in on them vocals, pull it up about 6 dB or something like that. Alright, let me create 2 sections because we have 2 different vocal pieces going on and it's competing for attention. So let's get rid of this thing here. There we go. Pretty delay 3, baby, ping pong, full pan width. I'm going really fast, I know. Turn down the wet input, wet, turn down the output, wet, turn down the level, and let's do band pass filter. And I meant to mention this, the bit reduction in the, basically you have a bit crusher type of sound. You can get that robotic sound. So we can get add like a little, you hear it go, wait, listen. Sounds like I'm talking through a walkie talkie. That helps it cut through the mix. Very creative plugin. Let's add that reverb. Turn the wet level up. Cut out the lows. Yeah. just going to add a limiter. This is not mastering by any means. I'm just adding a limiter to boost up the levels a bit. It's going to pump the gain. You don't get FL 12.5, what are you doing with your life? I don't know. But if you want to see the full video with all the features, I didn't even touch on, I think, even half of the features. Go to the Image Line channel. I'm going to leave a video link below. Just click there. You're going to see the full 12.5 video. This, I mean, really, it's about inspiration. And this is inspiring. Very fun. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to continue the FL Studio series where we show you how to make tracks using only stock FL Studio plugins, go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let me say that real slow because I really ran through that. BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. I'm still hyped from 12.5. You're going to see a bunch of videos coming out soon with only FL plugins. BusyWorksBeats.com.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master Music Theory. Visit BusyWorksBeats.com/Music Theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at BusyWorksBeats.com/Mac.
Who else wants to learn how to make beats like the pros and live the freedom lifestyle? You will never be a starving artist again after you learn the secrets of the pros. I've taught over 250,000 producers and songwriters around the world, teaching them Billboard charting techniques and insider producer and engineering information. And today, I want to guide you step by step in music production to build your music career easily. Just click that link below to get started now. You will learn sound design, sampling, sound selection, song structure, DAW functionality, mixing, mastering, and secret music production techniques which separate the hit records from the rest. We have trained over 250,000 music producers and artists around the world and have helped Grammy awarded and nominated clients as well. We've even partnered with top brands in the music industry. There's absolutely nothing to lose. It's free to get started now. If you take this full free course and still don't understand music production, email our support team and we'll guide you to the next step. Click that link below to get started today. If you join us in the next 15 minutes, you'll get a secret bonus. You have my personal guarantee that if you don't make better music within the next 30 days after taking all of our free beginner's materials, I and my support team will guide you step by step into the next level of music production so you can get your career started faster.